रिस्पेक्टेड आईसी प्रिंसिपल डॉक्टर गीता मेनन, वाइस प्रिंसिपल प्रोफेसर नीलम कपूर, एचओडी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ अकाउंटेंसी प्रोफेसर एलेक्जेंडर वर्गिस, एचओडी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स स्टीव सर, डियर मेंबर्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आर्केड तलरेजा कॉलेज आई वेलकम यू टू दिस एबीसी ऑफ स्टॉक मार्केट वेबिनार विच इज हेल्ड ऑन जूम प्लेटफॉर्म टूडे. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट आर आईसी प्रिंसिपल टू एड फ्यू वर्ड्स अबाउट दिस सेमिनार. ओवर टू यू मैम.
थैंक यू भरत सर. एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस यस वेरी क्लियर.
यस थैंक यू. Our esteemed guest for the day, Dr. Riya Nathani, speaker of the day and associated to BIAP, Board of Industrial and Academic Partnership, HOD of Vice Principal Neelam Kapoor Madam, HOD of Accounts Alexander Sir, HOD of Commerce Steve Sir, all my teacher colleagues from the Department of Accounts and Commerce and other departments, and my dear student friends. Good morning to one and all. In this COVID scenario, COVID-19 pandemic situation, we are all educating ourselves in various fields through this online platform. And today we are here again to know about the stock market. Commerce, which is nothing but the share market, it's an aspect of business. Now, this stock market has an history of more than 400 years. That is, it was established in the 17th century during the East India Company. Now, understand, trade started then, and the stock market again. Today, in India, I think the history goes back to 1875, the Bombay Stock Exchange. And later in Mumbai, we have two stock exchange, that is a National Stock Exchange also. Now, student, this branch of commerce, I don't call it commerce. Commerce means business. This branch of the business is very exciting, very lucrative, and has shown the world a good boom and a good crash, as with the same speed. Yes, you become rato-rat very rich, or you may become rato-rat very poor. But then there are thousands of examples in the society, among us, who are all safe players. So what we do learn from this? We learn that with patience, with care, with complete good study, a person can be a good player in this bull, that is the stock market. Aapne bull ko dekha hai. Bull kabhi bhi sar niche karke maarne aata hai. So if you want to learn the trade and actually enjoy the trade, there is lot of nasha hai is trade mein, is business mein. So what we would like, we want you to know the pros and cons. Isme kya sahi hai, kya acha hai, kaise karna hai, or we want you to know the difficulties also, the danger also. How to deal, with whom to deal, when to deal. These are some of the simple questions a share market player must know. It is a market where you sell your shares and buy your shares, not only shares, the bond or equities or whatever. Now, today we have a representation from the BIAP. As I said, BIAP is the link between the academy, that is students and college, to the industry. it is a representation, a partnership, as they rightly put it. A partnership where they want the students of commerce and accounts to know how you can be equipped in the market. So they actually are a link between the college and the students, and they form a bridge. They offer different courses. They give you certificate programs to make you a better commerce student and a better, means they make you skilled, polished, and employable. So students, I just as principal of RK Talreja College, and you all from commerce, okay, one more thing I would like to tell, share market is not only for commerce, it can be for any person. So all the students who have joined us, keep your senses open, listen to what our speaker has for us today, learn about the ABC of stock, and actually try to put it into practice and enjoy the session. Congratulations to the Commerce and Accounts Department for such an endeavor, and thank you to all. Over to you, Bharat sir.
Yeah, thank you ma'am for your words about history of stock market and what is to be expected from this webinar. Now I welcome Neelam ma'am and ask her to say a few words to our students.
Respected Principal Dr. Geeta Menon, respected HODs of Account and Commerce Department, respected colleagues and my dear friends, and most of all, to the guest speaker, Dr. Nathani. Good morning to all. I think it's a very, very good thing that Commerce Department and Account Department has arranged this webinar just 2 days after the Sensex touched the highest 50,000. It is a great thing for India, but I have a personal view that the Sensex does not represents or shows the economy we have. That is what you have to learn from these things. It may happens that you earn from the stock market sometime, but it is not always. That is what you have to learn. As if I see from the angle of career, there are many, many different possibilities in the stock market, not only for commerce, but also for science and art students. There's a big back stage work which goes on, which you can't see in front. But for commerce also, but you have to see that. You can go as an analytical, hello, can you hear me? You can go as analyst. Yes. And you can also go as fundamental analyst. Both sides, we need commerce people and also science people. As a physics teacher, I learned the theory of chaos, and I can see that market is always a chaos. So if you are trying to invest, learn that properly. And if you think that it is going to be a good career, challenging career, yes, listen today properly what they are telling about the stock market. Choose your area of work and then try to do that. Learn properly before entering it. It's the commerce people who are heading everywhere. They are at the top post, earning in lakhs. But you have to keep your fundamentals right. And I congratulate Commerce and Account Department for taking such seminars and webinars so that the students can decide where to enter, which particular field, even in the stock market. These words, I thank you to all of you for joining this. Thank you, Bharat.
Thank you, ma'am, for touching the career part of stock market, because normally students say that for earning only. So for career part of this, you have covered. Thanks for that. Now it is time to introduce our speaker, Dr. Riya Nathani. She is expertise in wealth management, and she is PhD holder in commerce, banking and finance, MBA in finance from ITM College, MCOM. Then she has done many various NCFM certifications. She is lecturer since 10 years in CHM College, and she is also a resource person with the SEBI for financial education since 2016. She's also a visiting faculty, and she has conducted many guest lectures and many more. So I welcome Dr. Riya Nathani. Over to you, ma'am. Riya Nathani, ma'am. Yeah, ma'am.
Riya, ma'am. Ma'am, you can start.
Is not audible. Unmute nahi.
Team Krisha.
The audio is very low. Riya, ma'am, the audio is very low.
Oh, yes, sir.
What is the problem? Madam is unable to join, or we are unable to.
Yes, yeah, she has joined, but I don't know, even I can't figure out why I can't hear her. She's not audible. Her audio is also on. She's on unmute, but I don't know why she can't hear her.
Riya, ma'am, we are unable to hear from you. Join from the mobile.
मैं मोबाइल से ज्वाइन करिए और हेडफोन डिस्कनेक्ट कर दीजिए. आई थिंक देयर इज इशू विद हेडफोन.
नाउ जब तक मैडम ज्वाइन करे. Our today's topic is ABC of the stock exchange, yeah, stock market, ABC. बहुत सारे हमने वर्ड सुने हैं, bullish angle, bearish angle, call option क्या रहता है, put option क्या रहता है, stop loss क्या रहता है, strike price क्या रहता है, target क्या रहता है, okay? Now stock market depend upon the demand and supply. ये जो stock market रहता है, demand और supply के ऊपर रहता है. अगर किसी चीज का डिमांड ज्यादा है तो स्टॉक का प्राइस बढ़ेगा. अगर किसी चीज का जो है डिमांड कम है तो वो उसका प्राइस कम होगा. जैसे जस्ट लाइक एज ए वेजिटेबल मार्केट, तो वेजिटेबल मार्केट में हम जाते हैं बराबर, हम मोल भाव करते हैं. इन द सेम वे स्टॉक मार्केट में भी ऑपरेटर्स रहते हैं. अभी यहाँ पर जो कल मैडम ने बताया, नीलम कपूर मैडम ने, के अवर सेंसेक्स क्रॉस द 50,000, एक दिन में 50,000 क्रॉस हो गया, नेक्स्ट डे वापस 1,000 पॉइंट्स वो नीचे हो गया और 49,000 हो गया. तो यहाँ पर बहुत बार ब्रेकआउट फेलियर होता है. तो आज हम यहाँ पर मैडम से सीखेंगे स्विंग ट्रेडिंग क्या रहता है, पोजिशनल ट्रेडिंग क्या रहता है, इन्वेस्टमेंट कैसे करते हैं, ये सब जो गेम है वो है पावर ऑफ एनालिसिस। अगर आपका एनालिसिस सही है तो आप जैसे गीता मैडम मैडम ने प्रिंसिपल मैडम ने बोला, रातों रात आप अमीर बन सकते हो या तो रातों रात आप गरीब बन सकते हो या पुअर बन सकते हो। तो ये है पावर ऑफ द एनालिसिस। तो अगर आपका नॉलेज है तो आप शेयर मार्केट से पैसा बना सकते हो। अभी यहाँ पर इंट्राडे भी रहता है। इंट्राडे का मतलब क्या रहता है, जो भी आप परचेज करोगे या सेल करोगे उसको स्क्वायर ऑफ करना रहता है। ये सब नए वर्ड्स हैं आप स्टूडेंट के लिए, बराबर। पर जैसे जैसे हम मार्केट में इंटर करेंगे तो हमको बातें मालूम पड़ती है, प्राइमरी मार्केट क्या रहता है, सेकेंडरी मार्केट क्या रहता है, डेरिवेटिव्स क्या रहता है, कमोडिटीज क्या रहता है। आप बिलीव करोगे हम गोल्ड को भी परचेज कर सकते हैं, सेल कर सकते हैं।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, थैंक यू सो मच, थैंक यू नीलम मैम, गीता मैम, भरत सर, सुमित सर एंड द आर्किटेक्ट कॉलेज फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग अस द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू बाय अप टीम and us to conduct this session on ABC of stock market. I myself, Dr. Riya Nathani, present over here, will continue with our session, and I warm welcome to all our students as well. So we'll share our screen, just a second. Is my screen visible to all of you?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, it is visible. Okay.
Yes. From behalf of Board of Industry Academia Partnership, along with the Architect College, here we present session on ABC of stock market. Now, this is one of the session on behalf of NSE, that is Investor Awareness Program. NSE, that is National Stock Exchange, always used to say that soch kar, samajh kar, invest kar. Now, we have a lot of different kind of avenues of investments, opportunities in the market. We have a good options as well. But we always get confused where to invest, how much to invest, and how much returns I will get. So that's the reason NSE has that kind of indications idea for all of us that whenever you invest, soch kar, samajh kar, invest kar. You first try to analyze, you try to see how much returns you are getting after beating with inflation and how much average return you are getting, how the economy is impacting, what are the certain corrections in the market, everything you have to analyze before investing. Now, this is what anyone from the student side, can anyone say? This is a picture of? In chat box, you can reply, anyone? This is a picture of? Yes, it's SEBI, Securities Exchange Board of India. Now, SEBI is one of the regulatory body who overall controls the securities market in India. Now, before SEBI, there was another regulatory body controller, that is CCI, Controller of Capital Issue. But there was a lot of scams, IPO bubble, some mismanagement, and a lot of unfair things happened. So after 1990, SEBI Act came into existence in the market. And now SEBI has a control regulatory authority power to issue guidelines, to issue code of conduct, to control overall securities market. So SEBI has a major role in Indian equity market. Now we are going to cover two important markets under securities. One is primary market and another is secondary. Along with that, the four major markets that we will cover today as the time permits: equity market, mutual funds, derivatives, and that is debt, debentures or bonds market. Now, first we'll start with the primary market. But before with the primary market, we just
try to understand what are the myths, what are the realities in the securities market. See, we always used to say, we used to speculate our market before investing. It is nothing but a kind of gambling. It is nothing but what you assume in the market, what you try to analyze in the market. Because, you know, as per the demand and supply of the purchasing and selling of the stocks, your stock market performance, your gambling, your reality exists in the market. So you never say, we always say that equity market gives us a stable return. Deta. Why we always, there's a fluctuating return in the market? Why? Because stock market consists of series of advances and that results in a net increase over time. It's a fluctuating return that it provides. Sometimes your stocks, you know, comes down. Sometimes your stocks moves away. How it happens? It has a lot of fluctuations. It has a lot of buying and selling power. It's a kind of reality that stock market is a gambling. So we'll start with the primary market first. What is primary market? Primary market is nothing but just a kind of where different companies, they try to raise the capital, maybe for the first time or maybe for the further. Yeah, anyone from the student side can tell me what is the difference between that is primary market and secondary market? Yes? Anyone want to say in chat box, you can reply. What's the difference between primary and secondary market from the student's side? We have a wonderful audience from the Arkady College, knowledgeable students we have from the commerce background. What is the difference between primary and secondary market? Yes, Dinesh, very good. Primary market is for the issue where the company try to raise the capital. Yes. Yes. Am I audible clearly?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Fine. Yeah. So that's correct. Thank you so much, all the students who have replied. Yes, primary market is nothing but where company try to raise the capital with the help of different types of issues. Because many of times I got the reply from the students. Students used to say, ma'am, primary market is for the first time issue and secondary market is for the second time issue. No. All the types of issues takes place in primary market only. And in secondary market, only trading takes place. So we'll begin with primary market issues. So what are the types of issues that we have over here? First of all, we'll see what is mean by public issue. Public issue means what? When companies trying to raise the capital from general public, more than 50 people, when companies giving open access to all general public to invest in this IPOs, in FPOs, in different kind of, you know, offers. So where offer is given to a general public, in that particular issue, company used to say that is a public issue. Then we have a right issue. I think this concept you have read somewhere, you have studied earlier also in 11th standard, in 12th, in FI as well, that when company try to raise the capital from their existing shareholders, then that will be called as a right issue of shares. If you are already shareholder of the company, company don't want to increase more stakeholders, company don't want to give more ownership to the different shareholders, they want to give facilities and opportunity only to the existing shareholders. So what company is doing, they may go for right issue. So when a listed company, then they, when they raise the capital, they go for right issue of shares. Then what is mean by preferential issue? Anyone have idea what is mean by preferential issue? Okay, yeah, someone said in chat box that I should use Hindi as well in between. Okay, Mohini, I will try to do that as well. Okay, what is preferential issue? Preferential issue is something where company is giving some preferences to some selected kind of investors like HNIs, high net worth individuals, some companies, some qualified bidders. Jab company kuch selected investors ko, rich investors ko, high portfolio investors ko, institutions mein se, kuch selected investors mein se paisa raise kar diye, general public ko allow nahin kar diye. That is called as preferential issue. Then next we have bonus issue. This concept, I think many of the students know what is bonus issue. bonus issue is something when company is earning good profit. That time they try to just share their kind of different profits with their shareholders. So what they do, they try to issue new shares to the existing shareholders. But here they will not charge anything. No money is involved in this case. It is a kind of splitting of shares. It is something kind of free of cost. Shares will be given to all the shareholders. Let's say the example, if you are already a shareholder of my company, so company will decide, now they will give 1:2 ka ratio bonus shares. So 1:2 bonus ratio matlab, agar aapke paas do share hai, to aapke upar do share ke upar ek share milega. तो अगर आपके पास ऑलरेडी डीमैट में 4 शेयर है तो अभी आपको कितने शेयर्स मिलेंगे, 2 शेयर्स एक्स्ट्रा. सो व्हेनेवर कंपनी बोनस इशू डिक्लेयर करती है तो कंपनी रेशियो डिक्लेयर करती है, तो उस रेशियो के बेसिस पे आपके डीमैट अकाउंट में कितने शेयर्स हैं, ऑन दैट बेसिस यू विल गेट एडिशनल शेयर्स. सो दीज ऑल आर द टाइप्स ऑफ द डिफरेंट इशूज व्हाट हैपन इन प्राइमरी मार्केट. अंडर पब्लिक इशू there are few more concepts that is called as initial public offering. Now what is initial public offering? That's called IPO. I think everyone knows that. When an unlisted company, remember the word unlisted company. Now unlisted company means when which is company totally new, still it is not listed with any of the stock exchanges, when they want to raise the capital for the first time, fresh securities from the public. So they will go for IPO. Many of the students, they don't know what is mean by listed and what is unlisting. See, you know what will happen? Whenever company want to raise the capital, jabhi bhi company ko paisa raise karna hota hai, to company ko primary market mein issue of capital karna padta hai. They go for issue of shares. They will go for raising of capital. But the, at the end, the company has to list with any of the recognized stock exchange in India. Because company secondary market mein pehle list hoti hai stock exchange mein. लिस्टिंग होने के बाद ही उनके शेयर प्राइस फ्लक्चुएट होते हैं एंड लिस्टिंग टेक्स प्लेस इन एनी ऑफ द रिकॉग्नाइज्ड स्टॉक एक्सचेंज इन इंडिया. ओके, कैन एनीवन टेल मी हाउ मेनी टोटल रिकॉग्नाइज्ड स्टॉक एक्सचेंजेस वी हैव इन इंडिया? एनीवन इन चैट बॉक्स कैन टेल मी? ओके, या आई हैव answers from Yogesh, Shashagant, Sally, Shweta, Manmit. Yes, we have two top exchanges, NSE and BSE. But overall, if I say there are more than total now, more than 34 exchanges now in India we have. So NSE, that is National Stock Exchange, and BSE, that is Bombay Stock Exchange, they are the top two stock exchanges. But now in India, more than 34 stock exchanges we have. Okay, so company after raising the capital, if they want, their shares need to be traded in the market. For that, company has to list with the exchange. Okay, so that was something listed and unlisted. Next, we have after IPO, there is another concept called FPO, which is similar to IPO, but only the difference is that in IPO, company is unlisted and they raise the capital for the first time, fresh issue. And in FPO, the company is listed. It means company already listed hai. Company is just trying to raise capital for the further expansion purposes. They require further capital. So what they will do when the listed company, already they once again, they try to raise the capital from the general public, that is called as FPO. But when the unlisted company, when they first time raise the capital, that is called as IPO. This is what your ABC of your stock market. This seminar talks from base of your stock market. Because directly once you will just watch Sensex, Nifty, you will not understand the many concepts. To understand the myths and reality of the stock market, you have to know the roots of this primary market. Only then you will start making interest and you will keen know how to invest in stock market, what are IPOs, because many people are earning profits in IPOs as well. But there is less awareness in the market. That is what these NSE, SEBI and everyone is taking initiative to create awareness among students, awareness among general public, so that everyone should have a proper knowledge about this securities market. So this is your ABC of stock market. Now under FPO also, there are some issues that is called as fresh issue. Same fresh issue means when new securities like an IPO, when new securities first time that is issued to the public, that is called as fresh issue. And when I say what is offer for sale, something which is unlisted company when they are trying to raise from existing securities. FPO mein aur offer for sale mein difference hai. FPO aap journal public mein se raise kar sakte ho, listed companies. Lekin offer for sale wo hota hai, jab company unlisted hoti hai aur existing securities kya karti hai, journal public se raise karti hai. That is called as offer for sale. Now, fresh issue and offer for sale, if you will not getting it, it is okay, but you try to understand what is IPO. IPO matlab jab company pehli baar fresh issue karti hai, unlisted company, journal public se raise karti hai. FPO matlab already listed company, jab normal public se paise raise karti hai. So IPO pehli baar hota hai aur FPO jab company already paisa raise kar chuki hai, fir se company ko expansion karne ke liye paisa chahiye. Again, company needs capital for further expansion. So they will go for FPO. So whatever the types of issues are there, that will take place in primary market only, because here company enter into the market, they issue IPO, they raise the capital, that is for your primary market. But this issues takes place for important thing that is called as ASBA process. ASBA, one of the important concepts from 2008 onwards, it has been launched, that is ASBA concept. Application supported by blocked amount. Very easy, and nowadays it has been initiated. What is that ASBA concept? Because you know what will happen in ASBA? Earlier, whoever want to invest in IPO, they have to submit a check to broker, then they will bid in the market. Then after 35 to 40 days, they have to wait whether they will get the shares or not. But ASBA bhi ek online process start ho chuka hai, jisme सिंपल आपका बैंक अकाउंट जहां पर है वो बैंक अकाउंट आपको लिंक करना पड़ता है सिंपल जहां पे आप आईपीओ में अप्लाई कर रहे हैं आप जो भी आईपीओ में अप्लाई कर रहे हैं सपोज यू हैव अप्लाइड फॉर 10,000 शेयर्स सो 10,000 अमाउंट विल बी ब्लॉक्ड फ्रॉम योर बैंक अकाउंट इट विल नॉट गेट डेबिट पैसा आपके अकाउंट में से डेबिट नहीं होगा आपके बैंक अकाउंट में क्या होगा सिर्फ पैसा ब्लॉक हो जाएगा फिर जैसे ही आप शेयर्स में अप्लाई करते हैं आईपीओ में बिडिंग करते हैं बुक बिल्डिंग प्रोसेस में और अगर बिडिंग में आपको अगर शेयर्स अलॉट होते हैं फाइनल कट ऑफ प्राइस के बेसिस पर तो 10,000 अमाउंट आपके बैंक अकाउंट से डेबिट हो जाएगा और आपके डीमैट अकाउंट में शेयर्स क्रेडिट हो जाएंगे लेकिन अगर आपको बिडिंग करने के बाद शेयर्स आपको अलॉट नहीं हुए हैं तो आपके पैसा जो बैंक अकाउंट में ब्लॉक हुआ था वो अनब्लॉक हो जाएगा And the best benefit is that till the time you are availing interest also in your bank account. Aur aapka paisa kahin ja bhi nahi raha hai. And you are not supposed to wait for further 30 to 40 days that when the allotment take place. So ASBA means application supported by blocked amount. With the help of blocking of your money from your bank account, you are trying to invest online in IPO in a short span of period. So within the 12 working day span of time, you will get all the procedures gets complete in your IPO. But for that, you require DMAT account. Now, what does mean by DMAT account? DMAT account is something, a kind of account where you invest with any of the broker. And in your DMAT account, you hold your shares in online form. There are so many stock brokers in India. Angel Broking Limited, HDFC Securities, ICICI Securities, Sher Khan, India Bulls, Motilal Oswal. So these all are the stock brokers. They are registered under SEBI. With them, we open a DMAT account and we hold our shares. And if we want to trade shares online, we should have DMAT account with us. Like in bank, if you want to deposit your money, what you will do? You will open your bank account with any of the bank, right? So likewise, you have to open DMAT account. So for that particular DMAT account, you have to just visit any of the stockbroking firm nearest to your place and you have to open that. So ASBA is one of the interesting online facilities in IPO. Just with the help of blocking your money from your bank account, you can invest in IPO. and if you get the shares then only your amount get debit, otherwise wo paisa block unblock ho jayega. तो ना आपको चेक देने की जरूरत है, ना आपको 30 to 45 days वेट करने की जरूरत है. एंड द बेस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट इज दैट योर मनी इज विथ यू इन योर बैंक अकाउंट ओनली एंड यू आर गेटिंग द इंटरेस्ट फैसिलिटी एज वेल. सो दैट इज द वंडरफुल फैसिलिटी दैट वी हैव कॉल्ड एसबा, एप्लीकेशन सपोर्टेड बाय ब्लॉक्ड अमाउंट. वन ऑफ द इंटरेस्टिंग कॉन्सेप्ट दैट द स्मार्टेस्ट वे टू इन्वेस्ट इन आईपीओ. सो फॉर एन आईपीओ, applying in IPO, what you all have to do, just a second, that you have to fill ASBA application form with your broker, then how much amount you are investing in IPO, that amount will get blocked, and after allotment what will happen, your amount will be debited and you will get your shares, and also you are getting the interest also in your bank account, the rightly what I said just now. So remember, this is one of the interesting and the new concept, that is ASBA, application supported by blocked amount. You have to remember few things. Whenever you open your DMAT account, whenever you choose any of the stock broker, you remember few important basic things, like you read the offer document, like when you take admission in college, what you will do? What you will see the application form, you will read the prospectus. Likewise, whenever you invest, see, read the offer document carefully, recheck your PAN number. Whenever you are investing, see your DMAT account number is properly, your bank account number is properly, and do not open many multiple accounts. Do not submit multiple applications. Do not fill any incomplete information in the form, because that makes a complex your trading. So that is the reason you are just a simple trader. You have to follow certain things to remember. What are the do's? What are the don'ts for investing? So that is very important when you will go for investment. There is also certain important things, that is offer document available on the SEBI website. Whenever any issue takes place, what are the IPOs? What are the conditions? What are the application forms? What are the issue processes? Background of the promoters, you can view everything. And there is one more also wonderful website that we have with us. I will show you at the end, moneycontrol.com, in which you can view so many analysis information about the company. You can gather a lot many information before investing. You don't have to blindly trust on your friends, blindly don't trust with on your broker. Ki usne mujhe bola tabhi maine investment kiya. No, you are now financially literate. You are gaining knowledge in the market. So you can take self-decision investment in the market. Now, how does secondary market function? Simple. Okay, before this, I want to ask you one question from all of you. Whenever you purchase some shares, when your shares will be credited in your DMAT account, can anyone tell me in chat box? What is the rolling settlement period? When you purchase the share, when you will get the credit of shares in your DMAT account? In how many days? Yes, very good. I got some answers, correct answers from few students. Thank you so much. The correct answer is T+2 working day. Correct answer is T+2 working day. So let's see the example. If you bought the share on Monday, when you will receive shares in your DMAT account? Give me answer in chat box. If I bought shares on Monday, when I will receive shares? Yes, correct. Answer is Wednesday. Why Wednesday? Because I am buying share on Monday. Monday is my T day. Tuesday is my T+1 day. And Wednesday is my T+2 working day. So when I am buying share on Monday, I will get my credit of shares on T+2 working day. So it will take around T+2 working days to complete your clearing and settlement of trades. So that is the realities and the myths that you should know for investments. Because many new investors, you know what they will think? Arey, aaj share kharida, aaj hi mere DMAT account mein aana chahiye. No, there are the certain procedures and the norms and the certain settlement and the clearing facility which takes place. So first of all, you place the order, trade will be executed, it will hit to your broker terminal. Then after broker, it will go to exchange. Then exchange will give instruction to the depositories and the banks to clear your trades. So this cycle will take around T plus 2 working days to complete. So here is a detailed information about the settlement, what I'm talking about. So you can see what will happen and when you will place the order, what are the certain instructions that you have to follow. See, simple what it says, जैसे ही आप ऑर्डर हिट करते हो, अपने ट्रेड एग्जीक्यूट होता है ब्रोकर के टर्मिनल से, वो यहाँ पे आपके एक्सचेंज में आता है. नाउ इट विल कम टू एक्सचेंज. नाउ एक्सचेंज में आने के बाद, इट मींस एनएससी एक्सचेंज में आपने ट्रेड किया है कि बीएससी एक्सचेंज में आपने ट्रेड किया, एक्सचेंज में टी प्लस वन डे में आता है. देन आफ्टर दैट एक्सचेंज व्हाट दे विल डू, दे गिव इंस्ट्रक्शंस टू द डिपॉजिटरीज. हाउ मेनी डिपॉजिटरीज वी हैव इन इंडिया, एनीवन, एंड नेम देम प्लीज इन चैट बॉक्स. Who will tell me? Yes. How many repositories? Yes, very good. Sonali, Yogesh, Samir, Deepika, very good. NSDCL and CDSL. These are the two depositories that we have in India that gives the that give us a kind of facility that we can hold our shares in online form. You have read somewhere, if you want to convert our physical shares into online form, that is called as dematerialization. So that dematerialization takes place only with the help of depositories. Yes, you all are right. Wonderful audience that I have today. You all are communicating in a better way. And I'm really feeling happy that you all are taking participant in the session and giving the answers. So what will happen on the T plus working day? Exchange will give instruction to depositories to credit the shares. Okay, then exchange also will give instructions to the banks ki bhai agar seller ne sell kiya to uske account mein paisa credit karna aur buyer ke account mein se paisa debit karna. Aur depositories ko instruction diya jata hai ki buyer ke account mein shares ko credit karo aur sellers ke demat account mein se shares debit karo. So likewise, the settlement of the shares will done by the depositories and clearing banks will do overall settlement of the funds. So there are the certain clearing members, custodians, which is called as. Custodians क्या करते हैं? Exchange की behalf में हमें clearing house के under custodians shares को custody में hold करती है और custody के through ही वो shares depository के through investor के demat account में जाते हैं. So custodians कौन होते हैं? There are the certain banks which are appointed under the clearing houses of exchange. और वो बैंक्स कस्टडियन का रोल प्ले करते हैं और एक्सचेंज के अंदर शेयर्स को कस्टडी में रखते हैं. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द फंक्शन ऑफ द सेकेंडरी मार्केट, व्हाई द टी प्लस टू डेज टेक्स प्लेस. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट साइकिल दैट यू ऑल शुड नो अबाउट इट, कि हाउ द सेकेंडरी मार्केट फंक्शन रन्स. सो जस्ट विद इन दैट टी प्लस टू वर्किंग डे योर सेटलमेंट टेक्स प्लेस. ओके, नाउ दिस इज वन ऑफ द इंटरेस्टिंग काइंड ऑफ एक्टिविटी फॉर यू ऑल. All of you give answer. If I bought the shares on Monday, Monday is my trade day. My settlement takes place on Wednesday. Correct? Now give me answer. Next question. If my trading day is Tuesday, when I will get shares? If I bought on 2nd of calendar on Tuesday, अगर मैंने अभी Tuesday को share खरीदा है, तो मेरे DMAT account में कब आएंगे shares? Anyone? Yes, wonderful. I will get shares on Thursday. Why? क्योंकि मेरा Tuesday T plus day होगा. This is my T plus T day. Wednesday T plus one और Thursday होगा T plus two working day. Very good. So the correct settlement period will be on Thursday. Perfect. Then we have Friday. The next question. अगर मैं Friday को trade करती हूँ, this is something tricky question for all of you. अगर मैंने शेयर फ्राइडे को बाय किया, माय ट्रेडिंग डे इज ऑन फ्राइडे, व्हेन आई विल रिसीव माय शेयर्स इन माय डीमैट अकाउंट? समवन सेज मंडे, समवन सेज ट्यूसडे. व्हाई देयर इज लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ एम्बिग्यूटी इन आंसर्स. या टी ट्रेडिंग डे होना चाहिए. सो माय करेक्ट आंसर इज Wednesday. Why? Because, see, I have not told you, this is some hidden information. Friday को अगर मैं normally share खरीदती हूँ, तो Friday मेरा T day होता है, ठीक है? Saturday and Sunday your market does not work, right? तो Saturday Sunday आपका क्या हुआ? Non working day हो गया, right? तो Tuesday Monday होगा मेरा टी प्लस वन वर्किंग डे, तो मेरा क्या हो गया मंडे टी प्लस वन हो गया, और ट्यूसडे मेरा क्या होता है बेसिकली टी प्लस टू डे। और एक्चुअली मेरा शेयर सेटलमेंट ट्यूसडे को होना चाहिए 9th को, लेकिन मेरा शेयर अगर वेनेसडे को सेटल हो रहा है तो मतलब मंडे को गवर्नमेंट हॉलीडे होगा, और अगर मंडे को गवर्नमेंट हॉलीडे नहीं होगा तो आपका ट्यूसडे को सेटलमेंट होगा, लेकिन अभी आपका मंडे को गवर्नमेंट हॉलीडे है तो आपका मंडे को नॉन वर्किंग डे होगा। तो इसके लिए अगर मैं फ्राइडे को शेयर खरीदती हूँ तो सैटरडे नॉन वर्किंग डे, संडे नॉन वर्किंग डे, मंडे नॉन वर्किंग डे, ट्यूसडे हो जाएगा मेरा टी प्लस वन वर्किंग डे, और मेरा वेनेसडे हो जाएगा टी प्लस टू वर्किंग डे। सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द सेटलमेंट पीरियड टेक्स प्लेस। ओके, सो होप यू ऑल आर गेटिंग विद दिस कॉन्सेप्ट। ओके, आंसर प्लीज स्टॉप रिकॉर्डिंग। Ancha, you are there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, stop recording.
Ma'am, I'm not recording. I think someone else is recording.
Someone else is recording?
Yeah, I'm not. It's not recording from my laptop.
So give instructions to them, no?
I think the college is recording.
No, no, from our side.
Yes.
Bharat sir?
Yeah, it is recording.
In your college, if you're doing it, it is okay. It's okay. I thought from my bio team, they are recording. Now, I will try to share some of the interesting news that how on 21st January, basically, the Sensex market has touched 20,000 points. This is the live market news that we should know about. In 2019, we have seen that from February onwards, we have a lot of COVID situation in all over the places in the world. There was a huge lockdown and there was a lot of negative impacts, economic crisis, global level, everything is impacted, negative inflation. There were many people lost the job. There was a big crisis, big recession going on overall. So this COVID situation badly impacted overall in the negative manner. But then too, what happened? There was a big achievement on 21st January. Our BSE Sensex crossed 50,000. Now, what is Sensex and Nifty? Can anyone say in chat box what is Sensex and Nifty? Because you are learning ABC of stock market. So I want from the roots need to be explained of the stock market. Yes, from the BSE, for the under BSE, we have a Sensex, and under Nifty NSE, we have a Nifty 50, right? सो बी एस सी में आपके टॉप 30 कंपनी जो है वो सेंसेक्स में लिस्टेड होते हैं, और एनएससी के अंडर आपके टॉप 50 कंपनीज होती हैं जो वो निफ्टी 50 में होते हैं। सो ओवरऑल हमारे इंडियन इक्विटी मार्केट के बैरोमीटर को जब मुझे जज करना है, आई विल ट्राई टू सी सेंसेक्स एंड निफ्टी। सो यू हैव सीन ऑन 21st जनवरी आर बी एस सी सेंसेक्स क्रॉसेस 50,000 पॉइंट्स फर्स्ट टाइम, बिगेस्ट अचीवमेंट इवन इन दिस सिचुएशन, बैड सिचुएशन पीरियड। नाउ you have seen a wonderful kind of scenario overall among the investors, among the participants and the members overall in the Indian equity market. Wonderful kind of achievement that we have seen. Okay, now before with that, I must try to say that even in 2008, there was a big scam. Can anyone say what happened in 2008? Anyone in chat box? Can anyone reply what happened in 2000? Which scam happened? That time also our Indian market got drastically affected. Yes, we have a, yes, wonderful Lehman Brothers Investment Bank that got vanished. Yes, where was a wonderful answers I'm getting? Satyam company, the top IT company. Yes, Satyam company. Yes, Satyam company, they did a lot of manipulation in the books of accounts and a lot of scams happened in 2008. So badly our economic got affected. So that time also our market crashed drastically. Just a second. Screen is, my screen is visible?
Not.
Just a second. I lost my some technical issue. I will connect once again. Thank you. Okay, till the time my system gets connect, I will continue. Okay, so we have seen on 21st January, there was a big, peak highest achievement that we have received in Sensex, 50,000 points cross. Now, what are the major reasons that we have seen that why this, even this economic bad situation as well, even the foreign markets also affected, like in US, we have a NASDAQ, we have a London Stock Exchange, we have a Tokyo Stock Exchange, everybody's, negatively impacted. But even in this kind of situations in India, we have seen that why our Sensex is performing well. What are the major reasons for that we are getting the good inflow in our market? Can anyone try to share some their inputs in chat box? Yes. Okay. Yeah. Audible, I'm audible?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. So we have the reasons, like, first of all, if I say we have a good corporate earnings, like if I say the Reliance Future Group, their quarter results are performing best. And we have a vaccine involvement initiative has been taken place. Then we have a wonderful kind of new appointment of the president. Just a second, I will connect. Just a second, I lost my technical issue. Okay. Just a second. I'm sharing my screen. You will get so many information. Ancha, give me a 30 to share the screen.
Ma'am, I've made you the co-host.
Okay, now is my screen is visible?
Yes, yeah. Yes.
Okay, yeah, sorry, really sorry for the technical issue today. What I don't know what I'm facing. Okay, so we have seen there was a wonderful kind of achievement that we have received on 21st January. How the market has peaked, we have crossed 50,000 points. And there are a lot many reasons for the same. One of my analysis results says that, from the February 2020 onwards, we have seen there was a negative impact because of the COVID situation. There was a negative inflow. There was a less liquidity in the Indian equity market from the period January to October 2020, due to which a lot of, negative crores of investments happened. Many people, they lost the confidence and they have withdrawn their capital from the market. But after October 2020, I have seen that in Indian equity market, there was a, interest taken place by the foreign investors, foreign institution investor. They have a good kind of, kind of speculation in their mind that really they are very optimistic in Indian equity market, how these industries and some of the good kind of different companies, they are having good corporate returns. So day by day after the October 2020, many FIIs, that is foreign institution investors, they have invested a lot in our Indian capital market, and more than 55,000 crores of inflow has raised from November 2020 till now. So that has given a huge liquidity positive crunch in Indian equity market. So that has results to a good achievement in the Sensex on 21st January, where we have crossed 50,000 points. there are the certain reasons for the same, that how the Sensex has crossed, what are the positive, top positive points that has impacted. One of the my best reason that we have the, can anyone say from this, this from the image what I'm trying to show? Latest what happened in US? Anyone? Write in chat box. Yes, Joe Biden, the new US president elected. So just, you know, 2 days before when Sensex has reached to 50,000 points, before 2-3 days, on Thursday, basically, we have seen that Joe Biden took charge as a US president. So globally, there was a kind of a hit record high on particular the same day. And there was a kind of additional boost in the market. And that was a major reason also that many people very optimistic about the market at the global level. Then one more reason, Reliance Future deal approved. Yes. So we have a good kind of quarter results from the Reliance Future deal. And they have almost have a good quarter of more than 3% higher after the market when SEBI have given them approval regarding their deal in the future group. And they have a wonderful returns, more than 24,713 crore from the Reliance Industries. This is one of the good corporate earnings. Then we also have a good corporate earnings from few of the companies. Like some of the companies, like if I say, I will show you. Yes, this is the Economic Times website. So you can see the best quarter results from the corporates like SBI, HDFC Life, then we have a Yes Bank, then from JSW Steel, then we have a SBI Life. The quarter results, their corporate earnings were really, I can say, more than 10 times, or I can say literally jumped double than the expected. So overall, in that particular last 4 to 5 months, even in the lockdown situation, even many companies, their employees are working from home, they have reduced the expenses, they have cut down all the unwanted other expenses, and they try to really hard work and achieve more than their expected returns. So you can say bygone company, WNS, then we have Reliance, we have a Bajaj Auto, many IT companies, Infosys. Their quarter results and the net profits really jumped at the estimate, more than the estimate things. So that was also one of the wonderful reasons that we have with us. And after that, I must say, yeah, this is about the corporate earnings. Then you can see this is the last history that how from this BSE Sensex, they have started with this 100 point and you know, the major reason that in the last 4 months we have seen that after the COVID situation, there is a less investment in bank FDs and in PPFs account. But there is a high investment majorly in gold and in Sensex. Since last few period, you are watching that how the gold prices are drastically moving and even the stock indices that moving drastically in the market at a higher peak rate. Because you have seen the banks are nowadays giving less interest rate on bank FDs, hardly 6% or 6.5%. So because of the good record of the foreign inflows since October 2020, you know what happened? We have a good back from the global investor and a good liquidity crunch in the market. And that really have an additional boost and that will give a hit to a market. So this is one of the screenshot of the news I have sharing with you all. And how from 2015, we have seen the market from 25,000, then it reached to 30,000 in 2016. Then again in 2019, it has reached to 40,000. But one more important thing I want to say that between this lockdown period, the stock market in few months, for example, in June, July, and in April month, there was a drastically bearish in the market. But not that much as compared to the foreign market. Foreign market bhi stock market mein gira hai. Indian stock market bhi COVID situation mein gira tha. Lekin Indian stock market itna nahi gira tha foreign investors ke comparisons mein. Why? because we have the good efficiencies from the IT industries, from the corporates, and one of the good kind of results that we are getting it. And we have attracted so many investments opportunities from the foreign investors. So that really have a good kind of journey milestones in India from, you know, 100 points when Sensex has been initiated from 1979, now it has reached to the 50,000 point in 2021. So you can see the history. That was one of the top gainers list in Sensex. So if you see the top five gainers as per the stocks wise, Indus Bank, Infosys, Reliance, and as per the indices that's called indexes. So under BSE also, we have a top indices who have a wonderful more than 100% change in their market behavior. That is BSE IT, BSE Metal, BSE Auto. And there are certain, you know, different types of the capitalization of the funds, like S&P, that is Standard and Poor, mid-cap funds, small-cap companies, large-cap companies. So overall, if I say, overall, the market behavior was performing drastically at a higher peak level. So, you know, as per my analysis, I also must say that we also should have a positive optimist about the upcoming Union Budget 2021, which is going to come in, few days. So there have a little a kind of still positive news about the market, but definitely we also accept that scenarios as well, that in future, when the correction takes place, there can be a drastically down also in the market. When the foreign investor, when they withdraw the capital and when they will see good opportunities in some of the other foreign exchanges. And now you have seen that new US president has been taken place, new changes will happen in the market, a lot of mergers, accusations, a lot of innovations will take place. So there can be a time period, correction may come. And that time when the correction comes in the market, for that time drastically the market may come down at that period of time as well. So this was something about from my side. Hope I have given you the basics of stock market, knowledge, live information, everything, whatever. We are just trying to increase your knowledge. Still more are there, but as per the time permit, I'm really thankful to the college and the BIAB team to share this wonderful knowledge with you all. Thank you so much, everyone.
Yeah. So this was indeed a nice session by Dr. Riya Nathani. She has covered basics. We literally say A, B, C of stock market. She covered basics of stock market from IPO, the various sectors, and she put light on current scenarios, what is happening in the stock market. So we, on behalf of RK Talreja College, I thanks BIAB team and Dr. Riya Nathani for this wonderful session. And I thank all the participants, my teachers, students, I'm sharing the feedback link in the chat box. Kindly fill that. Feedback link aapke chat box mein paste kar rahe hain.
Wo fill kar. And I'm really sorry for the technical issue today you all have faced. Really sorry for the same.
And this is the part and parcel of a new era. So there is no issue, ma'am.
Thank you so much, everyone. So can we end with the session, sir?
Or can we take two or more questions?
Yes, definitely. Okay.
What kind of stocks would you issue for startups?
Okay, for the startup purpose, not only about the current situation, I must say, but when you want to enter into the stock market, I must say, don't directly take risk by just jumping into the equity market by buying stocks. Go with the mutual funds first, which find. फंड में आपके पास म्यूचुअल फंड मैनेजर्स हैं, वो मार्केट को एनालाइज करते हैं, मार्केट को प्रॉपरली स्टडी करके दे विल ट्राई टू डाइवर्सिफाई योर इन्वेस्टमेंट. एंड अलोंग विद दैट आई जस्ट मस्ट से आई विल शेयर यू वन ऑफ द वंडरफुल वेबसाइट विथ यू ऑल सो दैट यू कैन हैव एन एक्सेस. दैट इज वन ऑफ द वेबसाइट कॉल्ड moneycontrol.com. व्हेन यू विल ओपन दैट वेबसाइट ना यू विल सी lot many information, current updates, top stocks, top mutual funds. You can do your analysis by your own. So by this way, day by day at the initial level, you will get an idea. Then after mutual fund investment, after some span of time period, you will realize how the market is moving, how the market is gaining, what are the certain factors which will impact. So later on, day by day after that, you start your investment with the IT sectors, with the top mid-cap companies like banking sectors. So that way you should go your investment. So you can all of you see this website that is called as wcontrol or moneycontrol.com. This is one of the best websites that we have. You can see the live information over here. You can see the Nifty 50 as well. Just a second, I will share. You can see all information, all current news with the graph, with properly all. See, Nifty 50 currently is in the percentage in the negative manner, BSE Sensex. Along with that, once you will serve, you have so many options. You have markets, you can see news as well. You can see for commodities market, mutual funds. You will get top mutual funds. You will get your analysis information. You can track so many things from this website. So whenever students, you will get the time, please try to have an access on this. And you will try to gain knowledge first. Then you will go directly jump to your investment in shares. That's all from my side.
Yeah, somebody asking, so sovereign gold bond in two lines, what it is? Sovereign gold bonds.
I'm not getting, can you?
Sovereign gold bonds, what it is?
Yes, yes. So bond is basically that is from your debt market side, right? That which we have not covered. But I will tell you, bonds is something kind of for long-term investment. Now, sovereign bonds is something like what you will do when a government or sovereign bond is some instrument of debtness which is issued by national government. Why they will go to support the government for spending? It means when government need finance for maybe for any kind of economic development or for infrastructure development or to pay periodic interest, they will go for sovereign bonds. So you will have interest rate that is coupon payment on that. But currently, as compared to the equity market, these sovereign bonds, they are paying fixed coupon rate, but less interest rate as compared to the returns what we are getting in equity market. So the benefit in bonds you are getting fixed return, it is good, but comparatively less you are getting returns as compared to the equity. But when the market is very panic, when there is a huge recession, or I can say the market is stable, that time I suggest to go with the sovereign bond because it is one of the wonderful debt instrument which is issued by the government. And it is denominated in foreign domestic currency as well. So that time I just suggest you can go for foreign sovereign investment, but not now in this situation. Okay, anything else?
Intraday, some viewers, intraday.
Yes. What is intraday? In just span of next 2 minutes, I cannot explain you in detail, but I will give you a glimpse of it. Intraday is something like in the same day you can buy and sell with a margin trading. Like if you want to buy 100 Reliance ka shares, which worth rupees 10,000. So agar aapne aaj 10,000 shares khareede in Reliance ke, तो आज ही कंपलसरी आपको सेम डे उसको मार्केट बंद होने से पहले 3:30 बजे से पहले उसको आपको बेचना पड़ेगा. अगर आप उसको स्क्वायर ऑफ नहीं करते हो, आप उसको सेल नहीं करते हो, तो एक्सचेंज ऑटोमेटिकली स्क्वायर ऑफ कर लेगा. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज डे ट्रेडिंग, इंट्रा ट्रेडिंग. सेम डे बाय किया तो कंपलसरी सेल करना ही है. लेकिन इसमें फायदा क्या होता है, आप जो शेयर खरीदते हैं उसका 100% अमाउंट आपको पे नहीं करना पड़ता है. उसका कुछ टोकन इनिशियल मार्जिन अमाउंट होता है 20-25%, उतना परसेंट पे करके आप शेयर्स को बाय कर सकते हो. जैसे कि रिलायंस का अगर एक शेयर अभी 100 रुपीज है, तो उसका 20% पे करके आप वो शेयर खरीद सकते हो. बट कंपल्शन ये है कि इंट्राडे ट्रेड, सेम डे ट्रेडिंग, सेम डे बाय किया है तो सेम डे उसको सेल करना ही है. उसकी डिलीवरी आपको T+2 तक नहीं मिलेगी डीमैट अकाउंट में, सब कुछ सेटलमेंट सेम डे होगा. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इंट्राडे. क्लियर?
यस मैम, आई थिंक It is fine now. We should close.
Okay,
it.
Sir.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you once again to all the participants. Feedback link is in the chat box. You can fill that.
Okay. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Wonderful audience we have. And thank you, team from the Architect College as well, for giving us this opportunity.
Yeah, ma'am.
Dole, ma'am, is with us. Dole madam is with us. Thank you, Dole madam. Sunil Khatri sir is there. Radhamani madam is there. Alka Golani madam. And Komal Chhabria madam is there. So share market means more pain, more gain. तो जितना ज्यादा रिस्क लेंगे उतना ज्यादा फायदा होगा, कम रिस्क लेंगे तो कम फायदा, मीडियम लेंगे तो मीडियम फायदा, तो ऐसा है।
तो अगर आप अपने एफडी में पैसा रखते हो तो 7% मिलता है, डिबेंचर पर 6%, गोल्ड पर 5%, रियल एस्टेट 4%, पर अगर आप पैसा म्यूचुअल फंड में रखते हो तो 12%, पर अगर आप पैसा शेयर्स में इन्वेस्ट करते हो तो द रिटर्न इज 18%। नाउ इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन यू, तो अगर आपको 18% चाहिए या 4% चाहिए तो उसके हिसाब से आप अपना पैसा इन्वेस्ट कीजिए। बट टेक्निकल नॉलेज इज मस्ट, अगर आपके पास नॉलेज है तो ही इन्वेस्ट कीजिए, वरना आप जो ये सब ट्रेडिंग है पेपर ट्रेडिंग कीजिए, खुद देखिए अपने, अगर एक्सेल हो जाते हैं देन एक्चुअल मार्केट में आप जंप मार सकते हो। तो थैंक यू टू ऑल फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स फॉर पेशेंस लिसनिंग। आई श्योर दैट डेफिनेटली यू गॉट द नॉलेज, इट विल एनहांस योर स्किल एंड डेफिनेटली इन फ्यूचर you are the entering in the share market. So thanks all, thanks to Bharat sir for cooperation, thanks to Alka madam, thanks to and the thank you to the Riya madam. So there is no problem from your side, some technical problem will be there, so there will be no issue. Thank you ma'am.
No, okay. Thank you everyone.
Thank you. We'll end so we are closing the meeting then officially.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.